for the longest time, I'm pretty sensitive to the fact that I'm only remembered for that one thing. The two things that hit me were that I come home and my wife tells me my younger boys want to see this match. They're probably 5 and 7 at the time. Kids at school have been talking about it. And I'd only seen the clips, you know, the clips. Jim Ross, good God almighty, you know, they killed him. Somebody stopped the man match. That had become iconic. You know, they're showing it in World Cup soccer games, Super Bowls and whatnot. But I hadn't actually watched the match in probably 10 years. So I sit down there with my boys and I watch it. And I realize that all these years later, man, it still really packs a punch. You know, like it's a ride. Like it takes you on a ride all these years later. There are people, you know, getting the legit goosebumps talking about something I did. That combined with Undertaker coming to one of my events in Austin, right? He and Michelle come and we start reminiscing and Taker looks at me. He still called me Jack at the time, you know, one of the last holdouts for my Cactus Jack. He says, Jack, what you and I did that night will outlive us both. People will be talking about that match long after you and I are gone. And it was almost like I feel this weight being lifted off my shoulders. And then I realized, wait a second, like I wanted to make people feel the way that I felt the night that I saw Snuka come off the top of that cage. And I've done it and I'm too stubborn to realize it. And do you know how many great workers there have been in our business who aren't remembered for anything? It's like, now I've got not only this match, but also the title change with The Rock. Like, I got a few things, and it no longer bothers me that I'm asked about that match almost every single day. It was, what a photo that is. Look at that ring filled up with people. That first time I go off the edge, and it's Terry comes out, Vince comes out, almost theatrically, right? You know, timing's great. And the second one. My brother told me, you know, he's watching it. My mom used to pay for the pay-per-views, and then he would show them to her the next day. And he, absolutely not. You're not watching this. And he said, I could tell when those people, they're in there. Sarge, we've got 3 referees, Sarge, Francois, Dave Hebner, and Terry, you know, they don't know what the situation is.
Just a heavy-duty moment and getting your mouth stitched up, heavy price to pay. Here's an iconic picture right here. I forgot about this picture. Dude, you've already been out there. You've worked that match. I had staph infection. I was in a hospital in Houston for 3.5 days. Flew there for the pay-per-view. Right. I'm working with Kane in the main event, First Blood.
So this is before your match?
Yeah, because you've already worked. So there you are. And I'm like asking you. I'm like, dude, I said, can you make it out there?
Because the timing is everything in this thing, right?
Yeah.